Let us see some rough idea how to generate the control signals. Okay, so this is, let's say, your hardwired control circuit. We will see how to design this hardwired control circuit in the high level, because to create a complete circuit for a computer is a big deal, because there will be hundreds of signals, otherwise hundreds of inputs we have to take to design the circuit. That's why we don't completely design the circuit, that is unnecessary, but we try to understand how to generally to do that. Okay, we'll see that, don't worry. Finally, end of the day, we have to generate the signals. Example, let's say this is your complete complete processor circuit. Okay, so this is, I don't show completely, but I show like this. Let's say these are all circuits. Okay, they are connected like this somehow. Now we know that, example, if it is multiplexer, then that multiplexer requires some control signal, correct? In that way, so this circuit already we have seen, right? These are all various control signals. So what happens is, so this hardwired control unit, periodically, for every time unit, that means for every clock cycle, it will generate some signals. Example, let's say this C1 signal is 0, C2 signal is 0, C3 is 0, C4 is 1, C5 is 1, C6 0, C7 1. If such kind of signals are generated, okay, and every signal is a binary pattern, 0 or 1, okay. Now 0 0 0 1 1 0 1, what happens is, this C4 is already connected. Example, this is C1 signal, this is C2, this is C3, this is C4. In that way, all these signals are connected to various parts of your circuit. Okay, so example, let's say C4 is 1, right? Then what happens, this will be enabled, this circuit will be enabled, whatever it is, whether it is multiplexer or ALU, whatever. Similarly, C5 is 1, right? C4 is 1, C5 is 1, C6 is 0, C7 is 1. So these three things will perform the desired operations, whatever it is, sorry, this one and this one and this one, and required operation will be done. Such a way we plan it. Okay, now this is a rough idea. Finally, what I want to tell you is, your circuit, if you see, there are various control signals, correct? So appropriate control signals are generated by your hardwired control unit whenever time proceeds. For example, you know one thing, right? So first of all, whenever you start the system, that will be time 1, that means first clock cycle, second clock cycle. For every clock cycle, your control signals will be generated, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, again T1 again, correct, T2, because it's a cycle, we know that, right? Only there are 5 stages. I can say that fetch, decode, ALU, then, you know, memory, then write, again fetch, in that way, T1, T2. So depends on the stage, proper control signals will be automatically generated by your hardwired control unit. For that, we have to create a circuit. Sir, but how to create a circuit? Already I explained you, right? What are the inputs we have to take and how to create a circuit. Now we'll see one particular signal. Example, there is a signal called RF write, recall. So we have a register file, right? For register file, there is a signal called RF write. That means to write into the register, we need some time, correct? That means we have to do it only in few times. When we have to really write something into register file, for that it depends on the RF write signal. So you tell me, when this control circuit should generate this signal, that means when it should send one in through the signal, is the question, correct? So finally, your control circuit is going to generate either, you know, 0 or 1. That means it is going to send through this signal either 0 or 1. Then when it should be 0, when it should be 1, actually when it should be 1, see here. Definitely we will be, you know, writing something into register only in the 5th stage, correct? Write register stage, we know that, right? How many stages we have? Fetch, decode and ALU, followed by memory. In the fifth stage, there is a write instruction, write phase. In the write stage, we will be writing into register, you know that, right? Especially that's why when the clock cycle, the time period is T5, that means, we know already I told you one thing. So there is a clock generator, did you remember? So that counter, did you remember that counter? That counter was generating patterns like this, T1, then T2, then T3, then T4, then T5, okay, then back T1, T2, in that way there was a counter. So whenever that counter generates T5, at that time only we have to enable RF write. Now recall, For every instruction, are we writing into registers? No. We have to write them only when the instruction is load, the instruction is call, the instruction is ALU. Whenever it is ALU, recall. Add R1, R2, R3. Then what are we going to do? In the fifth stage, definitely we will be writing the result into R1. That's why for add instruction, that's why not only add, for subtraction, multiplication, everything we have to write the result back. That's why for all the arithmetic logic unit instructions, ALU instructions, and for every load instruction, for every call instruction, we have to, and when especially time is 5, that means whenever it's a fifth stage, this T5 indicates that it's a fifth stage. Already I told you, your control circuit knows that which stage we are in, correct? Based on the this counter, correct? That's why, so finally, we have enough inputs, don't worry about inputs. So using the inputs, what inputs should generate RF write signal? That means when this RF write signal should be 1 is summarized like this. For that time, the counter should generate a time called T5, and that's why in the digital we write dot T5 and what else? Especially in T5 only we use, and especially the operation should be, sir, how do you know that whether it is ALU or not? Did you remember? We are doing decoding, right? So in the decoding phase, we will be decoding the instruction and we are understanding whether it is ALU instruction or load instruction or call instruction. For that, we have a circuit called decoder. The job of decoder is to understand whether it is ALU instruction or not, load instruction or not, call instruction. Already I explained you in the picture, correct? So that's why it's not a big deal for us to understand whether it is load instruction or not, call instruction or not. So this is the Boolean expression, I can say, which represents this signal RF write. Similarly, for every signal, it is looking very easy, but I will tell you, for every signal, control signal, okay, you know what is control signal, right? Already I explained you, right? So for every control signal, we have to write this kind of equation. After that, we have to realize a circuit, right? In digital electronics, you have realized, example, if you have a circuit like XY bar plus X bar Y, you know how to create a circuit for that. Similarly, here also we have to create a circuit. That is called hardwired control circuit. But generally it will be, you know, very big circuit, okay, and complex circuit, right? So that's the thing. And one more thing, especially for RISC kind of architectures, there will be a pattern, you know, repetitive pattern, I can say. The 5 stages also are closely related, and you know, our operations also, you know, periodic, I can say, and they are simple. That's why RISC kind of instructions, when you have, their corresponding hardwired control circuit will be relatively simpler than CISC kind of architectures. Whenever it is a CISC kind of architecture, then the instructions are, you know, they are quite different, and realization of that instructions, otherwise, you know, creating hardwired control circuit for CISC kind of architectures will be tedious, okay? So they will be very big and complex, more complex. That's why what I want to tell you is, generally the people realize that for, especially for RISC kind of architectures, hardwired control circuit is good, not a problem. But for CISC kind of architectures, this kind of design, hardwired control unit, will be complex. Generally, people don't suggest it. That's why, especially for CISC kind of architectures, they use an alternative mechanism, that is micro programming. Okay. So micro programmed control unit, will study that also, don't worry. So in the GATE exam, they ask lot of questions related to micro programmed control unit. Whatever you have studied so far is hardwired control unit. This is enough. Whatever I am teaching, you just understand that. Okay. Now remaining things are unnecessary and they are quite complex. So just this is enough to understand, I mean, solve any GATE question. Okay. Now what we are going to do is, we are not going to design any circuit, but we are understanding that this is the way generally people design hardwired control circuit. Okay. Now if you know these concepts, whatever I am teaching in this lecture, that is enough to solve any GATE question related to hardwired control circuit. Okay. Now we will see micro programmed control circuit. Okay. Micro programmed. Why we do micro programmed, especially we do for CISC kind of architectures, because it will be very difficult to design this kind of hardwired control circuit for CISC kind of architectures. One more thing, what advantage we can see in for any micro program control unit is, so it is like a program, okay? It is now like a, moreover, it's like a circuit. What's the problem with hardwired control circuit? I will tell you. Example, suddenly you realize that you want to change your instruction set, okay? You are changing your instruction, one of the instruction. When you change your instruction, then entire circuit will be collapsed, because this control circuit only works for current set of instructions and current execution model, right? Now if you change any model, example, let's say you have 5 stages, right? Fetch, decode, and you know, write, memory, everything. Suddenly you want to make it 4 stage model, then entire hardwired control unit we have to change. Otherwise, suddenly you want to change, you know, some of the operations. Example, you want to do, you know, RF write in another, I mean, you want to add one more instruction, something new instruction I1. There also you want to do this RF write. That means you want to generate that signal. Then entire circuit should be changed. That's a problem. Okay. So what I want to tell you finally is, if you modify your instructions, otherwise if you change any input to this hardwired control unit, you want to change, then this entire hardwired control unit will not work. So we have to restructure it, otherwise you have to redesign it. Understand? But if you go for micro-programmed control unit, you can do modifications easily, because we are programming the control unit. Here we are hardwiring. Whenever you do something hardwired, then it will be difficult to change. But in the micro-programmed control unit, what we are doing is, we are cleverly planning such a way that, so if you change some of the things, like, you know, if you change, if you add more instructions, still that micro-programmed control unit will work. Such a way we are planning. That's why I know micro-programmed control unit is generally flexible. Hardwired is not flexible, because that is one thing. That's why people go for micro-programming. But especially for RISC kind of architecture, generally it's okay, like, to have hardwired control unit. Okay, but especially for CISC kind of architectures, people use micro-programmed control unit. We will see that micro-programmed control unit now. Okay.